I'm Erin Harkey, Commissioner of the Department of Cultural Affairs and Special Events in Chicago. Significant parts of Chicago's history and future are present in this landmark building, the Chicago Cultural Center. Parts of the history of this building are the Grand Army of the Republic, Memorial Hall, and Rotunda. Throughout the years, the rooms have been used for public ceremonies, private events, and music and dance performances. More recently, a generous grant made it possible to do a museum-quality restoration of the space. Harboe Architects and a team of the absolute top talent in historic restoration have revived the Grand Army of the Republic Memorial Hall and Rotunda. Specialized experts in preservation have restored the beauty of the Rotunda's stained glass dome, as well as the artistry of the fixtures and walls to the way they looked in 1898.
There is nothing new about restoring historic interiors. People have been doing it for years. But when it comes to restoring the rooms of the Grand Army of the Republic, that's a whole different story altogether.
So there was plenty that was new about restoring the Grand Army of the Republic rooms. The design of the rooms, Charles A. Coolidge of the distinguished Boston firm of Shepley, Rutan, and Coolidge. You have people who did the original finishes with names like Tiffany. Also, leaded glass. The colors were worked out by the architects and Tiffany and executed by one of the great leaded glass firms of Chicago, Healy and Millay. In the 1970s, it was decided that this looked old-fashioned. So what happened? Those beautiful finishes were covered up with a bland coating of a grayish paint. And so the craftsmanship from back years ago needs to not only be recognized, but those original surfaces need to be restored.
My first thoughts when we were asked to participate in this fabulous project was I couldn't believe it. It was really, after 30 years of doing restoration work, this is going to be one of the greatest projects we've been involved with. It's basically like an archaeological dig where you see all the various layers of the treatments of the paint. And all the gray or beigey color you see, that's all overburden paint that was put on in the 1970s, and that's being carefully removed. You see a little bit further over there, you see the red paint that was underneath. That's the original paint finishes. And we found out that we were actually able to remove the overburden paint, the later paint that was put on, and then conserve the surfaces of the original paint, and that would be successful. That was really exciting because, as I'd said, we've never been able to do that in a project before. They're using a chemical, acetone, with little cotton swabs or cotton pads, and they're able to remove that overburden paint, which is fantastic. I mean, it's a really amazing process to see them be able to do that.
The scope of this project is a top-to-bottom restoration and preservation of the G.A.R. rooms inside of the Cultural Center. The real gem of it is the stained glass dome inside of the rotunda. And what a lot of people don't know is that there was artificial light coming through that stained glass dome originally. There was a concrete cap that sat over the stained glass dome. We've removed the cap. We took that apart and it's being restored fully, 50,000 pieces about, that are being taken apart, put back together. And we're gonna put a new skylight in so that natural light is gonna come back in through the stained glass.
So special craftspeople, the De Prado Regali Studios in Chicago, experts in leaded glass, were able to carefully take out these huge curved pieces of glass, carefully take apart the damaged leading, and then cleaning all 60,000 individual pieces of glass. With the work completed, for the first time now in 80 plus years, natural light will penetrate into that outer dome through the beautifully restored glass of the inner dome and then illuminate the interior of the space. Back in the 1970s, what was once clear glass was taken out and replaced by a dark tinted glass. In part of the restoration, it included taking out that tinted glass and putting in clear glass. So this was returned back to the way it was in 1897 with beautiful clear glass. Woodwork is an important element in the room, and there was a combination of oak and mahogany. These doors were taken down. You hardly could get an idea of how large these doors were until they were taken off their hinges. The height of each one of those doors? Nearly 14 feet. The finishes were returned to the way they were in the 1890s, and now you have brilliant expanses of beautiful natural graining that people didn't even know was there. Light plays an important part on how these rooms work. The light that comes from the newly restored bronze and glass light fixtures, giving beautiful artificial illumination that actually is being created to simulate the tone of the light that would have been present in the 1890s. The challenge is to bring this all back. Both the physical reality, but also the things that you don't see, but things that you can feel. So everything is being put back in sync.
I'm excited to invite you to the Chicago Cultural Center. Please come and visit the restored Grand Army of the Republic Memorial Hall and Rotunda, the amazing architecture of the People's Palace, and our other fascinating exhibits.